students. Once again, we went to continue our class. This is nothing as before. From our last class onwards, we are discussing about force of the parameters. We learn different examples in our day-to-day life. What are the examples of the forces, types of forces, such as like we discussed. That's what I'm writing to you. We learn what we learn about effect of forces, we learn effect of forces and how to calculate the net force on your body, how to calculate net force on your body and how to calculate net force on free body diagram. We learned already about how to calculate net force on free body diagram. So, and also we discussed the different examples to learn about to calculate how to net force on a different objects. Yeah, then coming to today, we are going to talk about effect of force on change of the what I'm talking to you, effect of force on change of the state of the body, state of an object or body. And also we can write effect of force on change of the what direction of your body. What I'm saying to you, state of an object and also direction of an object and size of an object and also shape of an object. Shape of an object. See here, what I'm saying to you, the effect force on change means by applying force on object, by acting force on an object, when you apply force on any object, what changes we can observe on an object? Suppose if your body is at rest, the body is at rest. If you apply any force on the body, if you apply force on the body, the body starts to move. Means the body changes its state from rest to motion. From rest to motion. Understand what I'm talking to you? See here, by what we are learning, effect of force on change of the effect of force. The force shows effect. How like it shows effect on object? By changing of state, direction, size, shape. See here what I'm saying. State, we are classing two types. One is rest, one is motion. One is rest, another one is motion. Okay, see here what I'm saying. So rest and motion. State means rest, motion. By applying force on your body, if it is at rest, it comes into the motion. If it is in motion, it comes into rest. So what we are talking here, what is the meaning of rest and motion? Can you say answer for us? Rest means the body which is said to be in rest, the body which is said to be in rest, the body does not changes its position, does not changes its position with respect to the surroundings in a given interval of time. In a given interval of time. Understand? See here, suppose the marker placed on my palm. Marker placed on my palm. By placing marker on my palm, also carefully, if I did not remove the marker from my palm by some interval of time, we can say the marker is in rest, because with respect to my hand, my palm, the marker does not change its position with respect to the rest given interval of time. The marker not changing position with respect to the surroundings. See here the whiteboard there. The whiteboard is in rest because It is not changing its position with respect to the wall. By that we can say what? There is a lot of internal organ, but the body is not changing its position. By that what we can say? The body is where? The body is in rest. Body in rest. There is motion opposite to the rest, relative terms. The body which changes its position, the body which changes its position with respect to the surroundings in a given interval of time. In a given interval of time. Then you can say the body in motion. Then you can say the body in motion. Understand? Coming to that, what I am talking, when we apply force on an object, when we apply force on an object, it can change its state. It can change its state. How it can change its state? Let's discuss those. See here, how it can change. A football player kicking a ball, which is at rest. Means what I am saying to you, football player kicking means he is giving, is pushing with his leg to the ball. The ball is already in where? Rest. See here, the ball which is at rest, the player giving a kick means giving energy or transferring to the ball. Otherwise, he is giving force, he is acting force on the ball. When he applied force on the body, what you may observe, the ball changes its position. The ball changes its position with respect to the person, the player. And also what you want to find here, the ball changes its state. The ball changes its state by applying force on the rest of the ball. See here, the ball comes into the motion. The ball came into the motion by applying force on the rest of the ball. The ball came to motion from the rest by applying force on the body. Understand? See here, you are riding a bicycle. When you are riding a bicycle, yes I did. See here, how like you can ride by pedaling with your legs. When you are applying force on the pedaling with your legs, what you can observe, the bicycle will start to move forward, is it? Of course. Suddenly you stopped, like a pedaling. What you can observe, slowly the bicycle will reduce the speed, gradually the bicycle will reduce the speed and finally comes to the rest. That is looking at a problem. Because the force is acting opposite to that. The force is acting opposite to the motion of the bicycle. So that is something as a frictional force. By acting frictional force on the body, whatever it came to the rest of the motion. Otherwise, if you apply brakes to the motion of the bicycle, if you apply brakes on the motion of bicycle, when you are applying brakes on the bicycle, what you have to do? The brakes means it breaks the speed. Means it upsets the speed of the bicycle. Means what we can observe here, when you apply brakes on the bicycle, what happens? Movement will change to decrease the speed and finally comes to rest. When we apply force on moving an object, it is changing its state to rest from motion. It is changing its state to come rest from motion. By applying force on object, what we observe here, it changes its state, either it may be rest or in motion. If it is in rest, it comes to a motion. If it is in motion, it comes to the rest. Understand? See here, by applying force on an object, what happens? It can change the state of an object. State of an object. Where should we observe such a like? In different activities in our day to day life, where we are, when we apply force on an object, we can change its state. When you are throwing a ball, before it is in rest in our hand, by throwing it, changing to motion from the rest. say applying force on that. Is it on that? Of course, when you are playing, when you are running, when you are kicking, when you are lifting. See here, what I am saying here, the body changing its shape by getting one force up. By acting force on that, by applying force on the body, it can change its shape from rest to motion or motion to rest, whether it is either it is rest or motion. Whether it is rest or motion. Understand? Do you have any motion to rise here, straight up and object changes by applying force? Is it or not? Of course, one more you can talk about. When we are moving, when we are riding bicycle, when you are riding bicycle, suddenly we increase the pressure, we increase the pedaling, we increase the pedaling, means we increase the applying force. You increase what you apply more force to pedaling. What you have to, before what speed you are going by increasing more force on the pedaling, what happened? The bicycle will move very fast. Means by applying force on the body, by applying force on your motion of your body, it increases the speed. By applying force on your moving of your bicycle, the bicycle increases the speed. By applying force on the moving of bicycle, the body comes to the rest. See, two situations we are talking different. If you apply opposite force to the motion of your body, it comes to the rest, it decreases the speed. When you apply more speed in the direction of motion of your body, it increases the speed. It increases the speed. When you apply force on the rest of the body, it changes shape to the motion from the rest. See here, how much we are talking in our day to day life, whatever activities are present, the applying force on an object to change it. Shape. One more we can talk about when you are playing carrots. Generally, the whole heap of carrots or mob of carrots are accumulated at the center of the carrots, center of the carrot board. The heap of the carrots or mob of the carrots are accumulated, are gathered, are arranged at the center of the carrot board. When you strike with the upper striker to the carrots, we have the strike, carrots will get to change the state by getting force by striker. When the force applied on the carrots by the striker, carrots are changing its state from rest to motion. From rest to motion. Understand? Of course. But understand how it is to change. Coming to that one more we can talk. By applying force on any object, you can change state. Means whether it is rest, it changes to motion. If it is in motion, it comes to the rest. Coming to that, one more we are going to talk. Direction. What I'm talking to you? Direction of an object. Direction of an object. By applying force on object and on an object, by applying force on an object, the body can change, an object can change its direction. Its direction. How much it can change? First we discuss here. A ball thrown by this direction towards the wall. Towards the wall. This is the ball. By hitting to the wall, it changes the direction. It changes the direction by applying force on the wall. By applying force by the wall on your ball, by applying force by the wall on your ball, the ball can change the direction. The ball can change the direction. Coming to that, a person kicking a ball. Person kicking a ball with his leg. See here, the two persons are playing a football in a football game. The ball kicking by the players, a ball coming towards the opposite player, the player applies the force with his leg in opposite direction. direction. Change this direction. See here, one more. Then you may observe if you can get the bowler throws a ball towards the batsman. The bowler throws a ball towards the batsman. By throwing towards the batsman hits the ball in different directions. In different directions. So the towards the fielder. Towards the fielder. See, by applying force by batsman with his bat, the ball motion of the body or moving of the body changes its direction. In this direction. Of course, what we discussed before about the caroms, we are playing caroms. When you hit that carom with the help of striker, the carom will change the direction by hitting to the walls of the caroms. By hitting to the caroms or wall of the carom group can change the direction. By applying force, what happens? The body can change the direction. The body can change the direction. Understand? See, by applying force of any object, the body can change direction. The body can change direction. Understand? One more we can talk about. Question about shape of an object. Shape of an object. Shape of an object. See here. By applying force on object, by applying force on an object, the body can change, an object can change its shape, but it can change shape. Can change the shape. How like it can change the shape? Take a rubber band or elastic band. Rubber band or elastic band. Elastic band. Rubber band or elastic band. Take a rubber band or elastic band and stretch it with your fingers. When you are stretching that, before it was in the shape of this area. By stretching with your fingers, what happens? It expands. It can expand. So the shape of the rubber band changes by applying force. The shape of the rubber band or elastic band changes its shape by applying force. By applying force. And also we can take a sponge. Take a sponge. If you stretch the sponge, if you squeeze them, if you squeeze the sponge up, squeezing of the sponge, squeezing of the sponge, otherwise, if you squeeze the sponge, squeeze them. What you may observe by squeezing of the sponge, squeezing to the sponge, we can observe the shape of the sponge is changes, decreases. What is its actual shape? It decreases by squeezing. By squeezing. Understand? By applying force on the particular body, it can increase the shape or decrease the shape. Means you can say it can change the shape of its actual. The shape of an object can change by applying force on that. By net force is acting on the body, it can change its shape. It can change its shape. Tearing shape. And you can say tearing. Peeling of paper. This is a paper shape. By tearing in vertical or horizontal. Vertical or horizontal. In vertical, it shows these two types. And horizontal, it can show such a line. By tearing, what happened to that? It changes actual shape. It changes its actual shape. It changes its actual shape. By applying force on the object, applying force on an object, an object can change its shape. The object can change its shape. And one more, crushing plastic bottle. What you can say? Crushing. flushing water, plastic bottle. Flushing of a plastic bottle. Or otherwise, flushing of a paper. Crushing of the paper. So, by crushing of paper of water bottle, what we can observe? By crushing water bottle, what we can observe? The water bottle can change its actual shape. It changes its actual shape. Means, by applying force, by applying force, what are you using the particular word? Crushing, squeezing, tearing, okay, stretching. Found one. Those are applying forces. A suitable verb comes to what? Applied forces. The applying force by crushing on a plastic water bottle or plastic bottle that can change its shape. That can change its shape. Understand? Coming to the operating part of what? Making chapati. Making chapati are good. Making chapati are good. Chapati are rolled. Generally, to prepare chapati or roti with a roll, ruler, means a rolling stick or roti stick, I come by pressing the what dough. By pressing the dough. It is the spiritual of the applying force by rolling stick or roti stick. What happened? The dough is changing its shape from spherical to flattened. What is your vicious your shape, triangle, mathematical shape, or circle, whatever it is. Understand? By applying force on the dough changes shape. The dough changes its shape. By applying force on an object, the object can change its shape. The object can change its shape. And coming to the breaking glass. What you can do? Breaking glass. Breaking of glass. By breaking a glass, what you can observe? It becomes as a thin type of the parts. Thin type of the parts. See here, before it was a wide shape with a particular geometrical shape. By making it, make, it becomes as an irregular of the thin type of the particle. By applying force by breaking to the glass, what happens? It changes shape. It changes its shape. So from these four examples, what we can understand, by applying force on an object. See here, what you observe, by applying force on an object, that an object can change state and direction and shape. And also it can change the size of an object. It can change size of an object. How can you change size of an object? How can it change size? Of course, size, how like it is possible? By taking a paper, it can change the size. Is it or not? Okay, change the size. The compress the balloon, you change the shape and size. The compress by stretching the inflated balloon. By stretching the inflated balloon, what happened? Change the shape and the size. Is it or not? See what I'm saying here. So by applying force on an object, you can change shape and size of an object. Shape and the size of an object. Now coming to that, what I am saying to you here, by applying force it changes the shape and size. Is it permanent or temporary? Is it permanent change or temporary change? Permanent change or temporary change? That we will discuss. The tearing paper is a permanent change. The tearing paper is a permanent change. And stretching the rubber band or elastic band. Stretching the rubber band or elastic band. After removing the stretching, what is the same flow? Same as its shape. Means that is a temporary change. What is that? Temporary change. Breaking of a glass is a permanent change. fermenting and a squeezing of a sponge. It is a temporary change. After many living the squeezing, it comes to the actual shape. So temporary. And crushing a water bottle. Crushing a water bottle is then also temporary. Again, it comes by saying filling a. So next coming to that, crushing paper. We can get it again for temporary. And making chapati or roti. Before burning, means before burning. Before burning. Okay, before burning, before when burning the roti or chapati, water, that is a temporary. Because after burning means after boiling, what happens? It never becomes as a dough. Is it or not? That's why by complete making it is a permanent. Before making goes, it is a before burning, before boiling it is a water temporary change. Not temporary change. Okay? Don't you understand? So the object can change its shape and size, state and direction by acting force, net force acting on object. By net force acting on object, the body can change its shape, size, direction, state, direction and state. Coming to that, one more we'll talk about. So we'll identify a new type of change in by applying force. That is nothing as pressure. What is that? Pressure. In our daily life, regularly we may heard the word pressure. Is it or not? Of course. We may heard the word pressure in our regular life. Then we also by reading, by more, by working more, by watching more, by looking. Means when we feel uncomfortable in our body, when you feel unpleasant, other way you may feel pressure. When you feel horrible by someone, when you feel commandable by someone. Okay? We may feel pressure. Where there is a bottle. Pressure. Okay, so we may also go into pressure. What is the regular? Is what is the general meaning of pressure? Okay, can you answer for that? Next, we discuss. Take a pen. Observe the pen. See here. It consists of two edges. One is flattened edge, and another one is a sharp edge. One is flat edge. Another is a sharp edge. We have to do, we have to take care when we are utilizing to do this activity. And we can take pencil, and otherwise we can absorb medium, we can absorb water, knife, we can absorb what you can absorb your dividers, compass. Just we have to absorb it. We should not do the experiment. See here what I'm saying to you. Absorb this pen consists two edges. Of course, one is a flat surface, one is a sharp side. Sharp edge means we can say here this flat surface we are calling blunt side. What is that? Blunt side. Blunt edge or blunt side. This is a sharp edge. Sharp edge, blunt edge. Okay, sharp edge, blunt edge. See here, take blunt side or blunt edge, place on your palm. Place on your palm. And push the pen from the blunt side to the palm. Is it possible the pen giving any pain or it is entering through our palm? No. Is it? Take the direction. Don't do. Just remember, just listen that. Take it on the edge of the pen, sharp edge of the pen, place on the palm. Don't do this. Listen carefully. Okay, just observe. So place on your palm, and if you try to press on our palm, try to press on our palm. What you may observe? The pen nib will enter through our palm. Is it or not? The pen nib will enter through our palm. Is it? Means the shark, before we observe, the blunt side pushes strongly but it not enter. The shark reacts just by placing what happened? By pushing very slowly also, gently also, the shark edge is entered through path. Is it or not? Of course. Okay? That's what I'm. So what I'm writing to you, see here, so blunt side by pressing more, it is not giving any pain. Sharp side, press very gently, slowly, it enters into our body. That's why we are using what? Knife, we are using knife to cut vegetables and fruits, always sharp edge. We are not using blunt edge. Is it or not? And also we can observe, when you are standing on the floor with two legs, with the two legs. What I am saying to you, when you are standing with the two legs on the floor, and when you are standing, just observe carefully, by standing with the two legs on the floor, by standing with one leg. With the one leg, means by lifting the other leg, so upwards. And one more situation. One is what I say, by standing with two legs. And another situation, what I am saying to you, you have to stand with the single leg by rising. Okay? And one more situation I am saying to you. See here, this is how like we are placing our foot. See, this is leg and this is foot. This is foot. We have to lift it out. Generally, this is the floor. But this is floor. This is the floor. Okay. And this is the floor. Means we are placing our foot. This is the floor. We place our. Okay. Which situation is comfortable to stand on the floor? Which situation is comfortable to stand on the floor? Which situation is comfortable to stand on the floor? Can you answer? Can you answer? See here, which situation is comfortable? With two legs, is comfortable to stand on the floor. With two legs, comfortable to stand on the floor. Another thing is, by standing with the single leg on the floor, by rising one leg to upwards, by rising one leg to upwards, it is uncomfortable somewhat than to this picture. This is first, and this is second, and this is third. So the second picture is uncomfortable to stand on the floor with one leg compared to the first leg. The same as third, with one leg we are standing with by lifting the angle. We are standing on the angle. We are standing on the angle. It's by rising the foot. By rising the foot. It is completely unpredictable to stand. Uncomfortable to stand. It is difficult to stand. Is it? What we observe here, by this situation, we are applying equal amount of force by covering more. More area we are covering between the foot. In this situation, we are covering less area. We are covering less area. Here, very less area, we are covering under our foot. In this situation, we are not applying much force to stand comfortably with our two legs. We are comfortably standing. In this situation, we are trying to stand by applying more force. We are trying to stand by applying more force to take the lift to avoid the fall. In this situation, we tried to avoid the unbalance. We try to avoid the unbalance faster. Is it or not? See, in that situation, very less area, we have to apply more force. In this situation, very, very less force due to the more area we cover. Is it? And also, we may observe in desert, measuring doesn't. The passes are not suitable. Passes are not suitable for riding in desert. Riding in desert. The only camels are suitable to ride in the desert. Is it or not? Why camels only? Camels are only possible to ride in the desert. Why horses are not suitable? Horses can run very fast, but camels are never run fast. Then why we are utilizing only camels to ride in the desert? Why we are not using horse in what desert? Because if you observe the foot of the horse and the camel, it's quite different. Horse foot is smaller than the camel foot. Horse foot is smaller than the camel foot. By that, what happened? By camel foot, it utilizes the more area, it can apply less force. Horse can apply more force due to the less area. When it walks on the desert, it enters into the jungle. Is it or not? And one more situation we can talk about. The porter. Porter means who are carrying the luggage. Okay. Porter carrying luggage on the railway platform. First he arranged on his head is wide luggage. See here, this is a porter. First he placed wide luggage on his head. Then after sharp wide luggage he placed. Then after very sharp luggage, then after very, very sharp luggage. He arranged such a light. By arranging such a light, what is the why he was arranging such a light pattern that luggage? To avoid the more force on his head. How we can avoid more force on his head? Because see here, by using more area on his head, by using a small cloth on his head. Because the whole force will spread out toward the surface. Suppose you have clearly, this is a transparent big glass beaker. Transparent glass beaker. Okay? And this is the water. What is this? Is water will fill in that transparent beaker. When we apply force by using piston, Piston means water which applies the pressure. We absorb the piston in syringe. In syringe, which is easy to plug, to inject the injection to our body. That is a piston. So by applying force on the water with the pump piston, we may absorb the water decreases the value. How like it can decrease? There is no gap to our escape of the water to our force. How like because of applying force by using piston, it adds force on all over the surface of water molecule. All over the surface of the water molecule. Means how much area of the water surface is consist. Throughout the area, the force will spread out what you are applying. Means what you can say, force, what I am saying to you, force is acting on unit area. Force is acting on unit area. Understand what I'm saying to you? Force is acting on unit area is nothing as a pressure. Pressure is what? Force is acting on unit area. Here, in this amount of hole, what happened? The force is acting on all of the area. That's why, what happened? We are using always sharp edge. We are using always sharp edge of a knife to cut the vegetables and fruits. Why we are utilizing sharp edge to cut the vegetables and fruits? Because due to the sharp edge, by using sharp edge, Sharp edge consists more pressure. Because of, where there is a sharp edge, it is less surface area. The sharp edge of the knife consists of left surface area. Due to the left surface area, pressure will be more to cut the easy to digestive fruits. If you use blunt side of the knife, the blunt side of the knife has a larger surface area. Larger surface area. So it takes less force, it takes less pressure. So it is unable to cut the fruits and vegetables. By that, what we can say here? So by more area, pressure is less. So by less area, pressure is more. So force is acting on unit area. Force is acting on unit area. Is nothing as matter? Pressure. Is nothing as pressure. See here. So pressure is a force is acting on unit area. So you can see here, force pressure is directly proportional to the net force act on the body. Net force acting on your body. Pressure is inversely proportional to the what area? What is that? Area of my body. Area of your body. Means what you can write? Pressure is directly proportional to the force. Pressure is inversely proportional to the area. From the what you can write? Pressure is proportional to F by A. So force is acting on unit area. You can get a constant by is equal to F by A. Means what you can write? Pressure is equal to pressure is measured by. Pressure is measured. P is showing the pressure. P is the symbol to show the pressure. Pressure is measured by. See here. Force is measured by Newton. Area is measured by meter square in the acceleration. So Newton by meter square. Newton by meter square. We can write this is Newton into meter power minus 2. Otherwise, write it here. Newton into meter power minus 2. For the same time, one more, you can write force. What you can write? Pressure is measured by SI system. This is in CC system. This is in SI system. This is in CC system. Dying centimeter square. In dying by centimeter square. Otherwise, pressure is measured by Pascal. Pressure is measured by Pascal. Pressure is a scalar quantity. Pressure is a scalar quantity. Force is a vector quantity. Understand? Coming to that. So, pressure is measured by such a line. So, by these situations, pressure is directly proportional to the force. Pressure is inversely proportional to the area. It means if the area is less, pressure is more. Inversely proportional. One quantity is increases, one quantity is increased. Okay? If the two quantities are inversely proportional, in the two quantities, one will decrease, one will increase. So if the pressure is more, area should be less. If the area is decreased, pressure is more. If the area is increased, pressure is less. Understand? That's why before what we discussed that examples. Why we want to utilize it? By utilizing particular situation. Understand? So to understand the pressure, I should discuss one activity. See here. Take a two metal press. Tray. We are taking visitor should wait, find order, find the arc, you can say, for the find stand. Find stand. To up the brim, up the brim. Okay, equal size is enough. That's why it's not very easy. Understand? Yeah. Take two bricks. Two bricks. Okay. What I'm saying to you? Two. Power of five stamps, we have to place two bricks. Two bricks, fine sand or powder. What I'm saying? Powder. Two bricks, fine sand or powder. Two place. So, taking two bricks, dropping from a height into the square. In one is the horizontal position, one is in vertical position. One is in vertical position. By dropping into that, what you can observe? What you can observe? By dropping horizontal into that, what you can observe? You can see here. See carefully what I'm saying. The brick can move. The brick move very less to downwards into the fine sand or powder. By dropping by this, the brick moves, deep to the clay and the powder. Deep to the clay or powder. Understand? What I am going to say to you, by dropping that, what happened? By horizontally dropping the brick that can move very less into the fine powder or sand. By dropping vertically, it can drop, or it can enter deep into the sand or into the clay. Why? Because both are same bricks, both are same place, both are same substance, what you can do. But just by dropping by different directions only. Why? One is moving deep, one is not moving deep. It is staying at layer on the other layer only. Because see here, the brick which is dropping in horizontal position. The brick which is dropping in horizontal position, it has a more area. That's why it appears less pressure. That's why it is not entering into the tray or into the powder. See here, by dropping vertical to the brick becomes vertically less surface area. So it has more pressure. That's why it is entering deep vertical. Means less area, that's why more pressure, that's why it enters deep. More air pressure, pressure is less, it is not entered inside the powder or inside the clay. Understand? So, what you have to understand? Pressure is inversely proportional to the area of the body. The pressure is more, its area is less, pressure is more. If area is more, pressure is less. Understand? This is our topic. We talk about different changes of air. Object by acting force on that. Okay, next we'll talk about how to measure the force and also different type of deforming force are there. Okay, and balance or unbalanced force are there. Some of the problems we may discuss on that. What we will learn them. Understand? Okay, see you in the next class. Have a good day. And recall all what you finish. Recall all what you finish. Thank you.